Hi, I am Gusev Alexander and present the talk algorithm for constructing aramid interpolation polynomials on triangle and tetrahedron. This problem is a part of the problem to construct height order schemes of the finite element method and mostly performed in the Joint Institute for Nuclear Research, Dubna, and Saratov State University. Our interest is construct the finite element method scheme for solving the boundary value problem for elliptic partial differential equations in atomic molecular nuclear physics, semiconductors, and so on. The problem solving in this talk is construction of the Hermite interpolation polynomial up to order p prime, joining which the piecewise polynomial function can be obtained that possess continuing derivative up to the given order. These polynomials are used for construct finite element schemes when high smooth slope between the elements is required or when the gradient of solution must be determined with high accuracy. The schemes with Hermite interpolation polynomials had the greater discrepancy of the same grade versus the scheme with Lagrange polynomial. So, but each, in the case of the Hermite interpolation polynomials, each node of the finite element grid will be common to more finite elements. To illustrate this, we present the result of solution the boundary value problems of Ortogonal equation for the equilateral triangle, which has the integer eigenvalues. On this picture, we present the absolute errors of the fourth eigenvalue versus the number of divisions of the triangle set and the dimension of the algebraic eigenvalue problems for the schemes with interpolation Lagrange polynomials of degree from 5 to 9 and corresponded Hermite one with continuous of derivatives of the first and second order. One can see if we can use only on same grid the result obtained by Lagrange polynomials is better than Hermite one, but if we as view this result with respect to dimension of the eigenvector, we see that the Hermite polynomials works better. In one-dimensional case, the Lagrange interpolation polynomials obtained by values of them in some subgrid are calculated by the known analytical form, where p is number of subgrid element. So, the case of the Hermite interpolation polynomials, which we give the values and derivatives up to the given order, are calculated in analytical way too. For the construction of the multidimensional Hermite interpolation polynomials, we use the following economical implementation accepted in finite element method. All calculations are performed in the local or barycentric coordinates and all integrals of finite element method is executed in the local coordinates too. In contrast to one-dimensional case, the interpolation polynomials in the multidimensional case are calculated by solving of system of the algebraic linear equation, not the analytical form. So, one of exception for calculate the interpolation Lagrange polynomials is presented on this slide. The algorithm for construction the basis of interpolation Hermit polynomials contains two stages. On first stage, we calculate the conditions to determine them. So, following the one-dimensional case, on some point, we consider only case, these points are only vertices of the simplex. We put the values of the interpolation Hermite polynomials up to the given order kappa max minus one. So, against one-dimensional case, this condition not form the basis of interpolation polynomials, but it is needed to add two types of condition. Second condition is needed for construction of the derivatives, and third type of conditions, it is needed for construction the basis of interpolation Hermite polynomials. For determine the interpolation Hermite polynomials basis, one of the right hand side of the condition is equal one, and other right hand side is equal zero. The correspondent polynomials we name by auxiliary polynomials first, second, and third time. In two words, the algorithm for for conditions contains in two words how polynomials needed, how polynomials we have. We illustrate the algorithm for calculation the basis of Hermite interpolation polynomials on example kappa p1 kappa max equal 5. It means the conditions for polynomials and the derivatives up to fourth order on each of the three vertices of triangle is done. So the polynomials of the 9 degree is 55. So the numbers of auxiliary polynomials is 45. So the conditions for the auxiliary polynomials of second and third types is 10. On each side of the triangle, we have polynomial of the same degree, 9, with respect to one variables z. So the polynomials of degree 9 needed to 10 parameters to describe it, but we have 10 parameters too. It's these derivatives with respect to longitudinal variables in each of two vertices of the side. So the first derivative is polynomials of the degree 8. For this description needed 9 parameters, but we have 8 parameters, mixed derivatives, but is first derivatives with respect to transversal variables. So it is needed one parameter. So to describe them, we put the conditions for the first derivatives and on each of three sides. So we have 7 conditions for determine the auxiliary polynomial. Okay, second derivatives. Polynomial degree 7 needed 8 parameters. We have 6 parameters is on each of the two vertices. So to determine polynomial second derivatives, it is need 2 conditions on each side. So we have only one conditions to describe auxiliary polynomials of the third type. So next, third derivative of polynomial of degree 6 needed 7 parameters. We have 4. There are no enough parameters, conditions to describe this auxiliary polynomial. So we have 55 conditions. 45 of them describe auxiliary polynomials of the first type. 9 conditions describe the auxiliary polynomials of the second type and 1 condition to describe the auxiliary polynomials of the third type. To obtain the conditions for the basis of Hermite interpolation polynomials on the tetrahedron, use the conditions of the Hermite interpolation polynomials of second and third type on a triangle. On each side of triangle or edge of the, we use the one condition for determine first derivative and two condition to determine second derivative. So in the case of the tetrahedron, we have 2 conditions to determine first derivatives between of two directions and 6 condition to determine second derivative, because two direction and mixed derivative. So we have full number of polynomials 220, number of auxiliary polynomials 140, number of second auxiliary polynomials in the all edges is 45, and 4 auxiliary polynomials of the third type in the faces of the tetrahedrons. So for determined auxiliary polynomials of the second type that provide the continuous of derivatives in vicinity to faces and auxiliary polynomials of the third type, we have 28 condition. In vicinity the 8, the conditions of the continuity of derivatives are satisfied automatically, but in derivative to phase. So we have polynomials of the phases, polynomial of the same degree 9 for its description needed 55 parameter behave. We have 55. So to describe the second derivative is polynomials of degree 8, needed 45 parameters. We have 3 by types by 10th derivative condition, it's mixed derivatives, but first with only first derivative with respect to transversal variables, and 3 condition is first derivative, and here is mixed derivative. So we have 39 parameters. It is needed 6. So we have this polynomials. We obtain the first derivative in 6 points in the side of the tetrahedron. So we have four conditions to determine auxiliary polynomials of the third and second type. So second derivatives, polynomial of 7 degree needed 36 parameter, but we have 22, no enough parameter. So the third type of the auxiliary polynomials contains 4 polynomials. In second stage, used the updated conditions, we construct and solve the system of the linear algebraic equation. So if matrix of the system is non-degenerate, we obtain the basis of interpolation Hermite polynomials when characteristic of them are present in these tables. The above algorithm can be applied to calculate the multidimensional Hermite interpolation polynomials. Some result of them is present here. It's well-known interpolation Hermite polynomials of the third order. Next, here is polynomials of the fifth order. So in each versus the values of the function and the derivative after the second order is applied, so contains only interpolation polynomials of the. In this slide, the auxiliary polynomials of the second and third type of the fifth order Hermite interpolation polynomials that preserve the first derivatives in vicinities of the edges. One of the main problems in the realization of height of the finite element scheme are calculation of the integrals. For this, we described some quadrature formulas, the numbers of points of quadratures of rules of orders P for triangle and tetrahedron is present here. So this one of examples of the quadrature rules. So the interpolation Hermite polynomials on multidimensional hyperparallelepiped obtained by these conditions for value of polynomials and the derivatives can be obtained in analytical form as product of the one-dimensional interpolation polynomials. So it's present example for kappa max равно that obtained the second. First, continue to do the first derivatives. So we compared the finite element method scheme obtained using interpolation polynomials on the simplexes and the hypercube to solve the boundary value problem for Helmholtz equations on the Kiper cube. For this, we use the following decomposition of the Kiper cube by means of symplex. So we choose two opposite vertices and go from one of them to the another by edge of the Kiper cube. So this vertices is a vertices of the full. On this picture, the discrepancy of the calculated eigenvalue of the Helmholtz problem on a square which has the integer eigenvalue is present for the scheme third order and fifth order Lagrangian interpolation polynomials. Here is Lagrangian Hermit polynomials on the square and by violet and red, the Lagrange and Hermit polynomials of the triangle. So the dimension of this problem here, but we see that the discrepancies are right inverse the exact eigenvalue are on the straight lines. So it's the same for five dimensions. The same result I present to solve the four-dimensional case using the third order interpolation Lagrange polynomial on the simplex and Lagrange and Hermit polynomials of the hypercube. So the dimension of the algebraic problems is 10,000. So we have the discrepancies are on the straight lines too. So we develop an algorithm for construction basis of Hermit interpolation polynomials on triangle and tetrahedron, which necessary for constructed high order computational scheme of n element to solve the different boundary value problem. So all calculations presented in this talk, except the calculation of the spectra of triangle, is done in Maple. So thank you for attention.